get boom boom boom, gotta get get boom boom boom, gotta get get boom boom boom, gotta get get boom boom boom, that boom boom boom, that boom boom boom, boom boom. Yo, I got that hit the beat. For 3 months, she has been the subject of relentless media coverage and public debate. If you didn't know her then, you would definitely know her now. Yet, through it all, she kept her head high and stayed strong. Razor TV welcomes former Miss Singapore World, Riz Low, to our studio. Riz, welcome to our studio. This is our living room.
Hi.
Hi. How have you been so far?
I've been good. Mm-hmm. I've been living my head high and taking everything with a pinch of salt.
Okay, so you don't really mind the criticisms?
I'm a person with actually very high self-confidence.
Mm. I don't really let it take any effect on me because I try not to listen to what people have to say because I know other people out there are out to support me.
Mm-hmm. There are people out there who support you. Mm-hmm. Who are some of them?
Like my friends. Mm-hmm. I have some fans on Facebook. Uh-huh. People that okay. I don't really know and uh-huh. they just add me on and
they become a fan.
Yeah.
Do you regret doing the first interview with Razor TV?
I'm feeling naughty now. I'll wear something red and loud. Something, you know? Booms. Something that shouts me.
No.
Not at all.
No. Okay. Because I guess it gives me the courage to speak in front of the camera. Uh-huh. This is the first time I'm doing it.
Is this the first time that you're doing an interview in a studio?
Yes, this okay. is the first time I'm doing it in a proper studio and this is amazing.
Lights and yes. multiple cameras, right? Mm-hmm. Is it intimidating to you?
Not really, but not really. I think it's quite fun to be out here.
Mm-hmm. So are you saying that you are enjoying the instant fame?
Instant fame? Not really, because it gets you too much publicity and uh-huh. people start to recognize you on street. Uh-huh. People will okay. be recognizing you for the wrong reasons.
Oh, yeah. So there have been people who could recognize you when you're walking on the streets and when you are in campus?
Yeah, in campus especially.
Okay, do you know if they are gossiping about you?
Somehow I can feel that they are mm-hmm. talking about you behind your back. Mm-hmm. At first, I was a bit upset, mm-hmm. but after that, my friends kept telling me that they don't know you, so they have no right to comment at all, and they don't know you, mm-hmm. they don't know who you are, what you are, and their perception may be
maybe wrong.
Yeah, it's wrong.
Okay.
Because
okay.
of what the newspapers write.
Mm-hmm. On the other note, have there been people who approach you to have photos taken with you or to ask for your autographs?
Yes.
Yes, okay. What kind of people, like your classmates, your coursemates?
Not classmates, but some random people.
Okay.
I was at this marathon jog.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Last Saturday.
So you're quite a sporty person as
well.
Yeah, okay. And there are people...
Yes, some students, uh-huh. they came up to me and asked for a photograph. Oh. And I'm more than glad to oblige.
Okay, so you are enjoying that as well.
Mm.
Okay.
I guess that's yeah. what makes so fame fun.
Have you always wanted to be famous, like, since you were a girl, like, a little girl?
I guess everybody wants to be famous. Everybody wants to be in the limelight. Mm-hmm. Only for what kind of reasons?
So is this how you imagine fame to be?
Yes.
Yes. Okay, with your pictures appearing on every single daily.
Yes.
What about your parents? Do they have anything to say about your exposure in the media?
No, they were really supportive of me. And even that my case came up, mm-hmm. yeah, they still stood by me and say that, girl, you're our girl. No matter what, we'll still stand by you.
Mm-hmm. So they are very liberal.
They are very liberal.
Okay. Have they ever advised you to stay out of the limelight just for your own sake? You know?
Of course they did.
They did.
They did. Mm-hmm. But somehow news get leaked.
Did they scold you about
no.
that?
No. They were really supportive and they stood by me no matter what.
Okay.
Even though there were times that I really procrastinated because I just joined this contest and I have so much publicity and stuff going on. Mm-hmm. They just said that once you have taken this step, there's no turning back. So you have just to walk down and face it.
Face it with courage.
Yes.
Right. So Riz was in district court earlier today for a review of her 24-month supervised probation. We discuss that in the next clip. Boom, shake, shake, shake.